Hi. I'm going to tell you that you already know how to program. And you may not think that's true, but you really do. You understand how to explain things to people. You understand how to give directions. In the 2015 film, The Imitation Game, Alan Turing posed the question, can computers think? And in that film, he said that, well, it's not really a fair question. And it's not really a fair question because humans don't think the same way that computers do. Computers think differently. Computers, unlike humans, require instructions to be broken down very, very small into very tiny, discrete pieces. When Julia Child decided to make her cookbook, Mastering the Art of French Cooking, she was writing her book for a group of people who already knew how to cook. She wrote it for housewives or just normal people, normal American citizens who wanted to learn how these French people made these big, complex recipes that were really fancy, and they were just so crazy, outrageously wonderful that nobody even tried to attempt them. So Chef Julia decided that she wanted to break these recipes down into very small pieces, make them simple enough so that an American chef could accomplish them. That's the same thing you do when you program a computer. When you program a computer, you take these big problems that you think that maybe only humans can understand, and you break them down into something smaller and smaller until it becomes something manageable that a computer can handle. When you tell a computer what to do, there are three basic structures that you can use to tell a computer what to do. The first is called the sequence structure, and that's just like following a recipe. If I open the book to this recipe for roast chicken, and it says, preheat the oven to 425 degrees, sprinkle the inside of the chicken with salt, smear the other half in butter. I follow the instructions step by step by step. That is the most basic way of programming a computer. You tell it to do this thing, then you tell it to do this thing, then you tell it to do the next thing. It's very simple. The next structure that we use when programming a computer is called the selection structure. Some of these recipes say, if you have a convection oven, you need to take these steps. And if you have a conventional oven, you need to take these steps. I have a conventional oven, so I would be following the steps with a conventional oven. The same thing when you program a computer, you might want the computer program to take certain actions based on certain conditions, and you would use the selection structure to determine what happens based on those conditions. Finally, you have the loop structure, and the loop structure involves telling the computer to do a certain thing as long as a certain condition is true or for a certain number of steps. For example, it says, allow the chicken to brown lightly for 15 minutes. So you might put the chicken in the rack in the middle of a preheated oven, and then until 15 minutes is up, you kind of sit there and wait for it. That's a loop structure. You also might be asked to mince a shallot. You can't tell a computer to mince a shallot. So if you wanted to tell a computer to mince a shallot, you would tell the computer to put the shallot on the cutting board and keep chopping the shallot. Keep chopping the shallot, keep chopping the shallot until it is tiny enough to constitute a mince. You have to break the concept of mincing down for the computer so the computer can understand it. So, all of these structures can combine to form a coherent program. So, if I have a conventional oven, I might take a certain number of steps in a sequence. So I can combine them. I can take the selection structure, select a conventional oven, and do a certain number of steps in that sequence. Also, inside the loop, when I am mincing the shallot, I'm going to take and rock my knife up, rock it down, up and down, and keep bringing the shallot into a pile, and keep doing it until it's small. That's another sequence structure inside of the loop. Now, you may not believe me that you can already program, but as you go on with this class, you will realize that yes, you can. You already know how to program. You already know how to break things down into smaller pieces and explain things, explain how to do something. All you need to do is now turn that into the language that the computer can understand. And I know you can do it.